So if we're going to investigate crystalline solids, we first have to determine what a unit cell is and what a crystal lattice is. We talk about ionic bonding as the transfer of electrons. So here we have a little snapshot, a two-dimensional snapshot, of this ionic bonding to form a crystal. Okay, so you have these positive and negative charges that are packed together in a solid really close to each other. And this arrangement right here goes on in three dimensions. So it goes along the plane of the page, above the page, and below the page. The size of the cation and anion will dictate how ions pack in a crystal. And typically, when we look at cations and anions, we think of spheres. So if you think about putting a whole big tub of oranges together, they're going to pack a lot differently than if I threw in a couple of grapefruits. And if we threw in a bunch of golf balls and bowling balls, they're also going to pack differently. And one of the things that we have to look at and investigate is that ions pack to minimize repulsions. Okay, so if we have a large cation and we have some small anions to pack around it, they're going to pack in order to minimize these repulsions. So if there's going to be another cation, we're going to have an anion right in between those. Because remember, like charges repel, opposite charges attract. Okay, so if we have large positive charges, that means we're going to need a bunch of negatives to surround that positive charge in order to minimize the repulsions. Okay? And another thing that we can say here is that once ions pack in a crystal, X-ray diffraction is used to specifically determine the arrangement of atoms. And we can get very, very detailed information about this and how these cations and anions and atoms and we can approximate them as spheres, how they pack together. And with X-ray diffraction, that allowed us to view all of these things. While we won't use the techniques of X-ray diffraction, we're going to use the results that we can get from this. So before we get into all of this, I kind of want to use an analogy. And if we took a bunch of bricks together, we can build a wall. And if you notice, if you look at the various walls, when someone who's in construction goes and builds this wall, they build this repeat pattern that goes on in two dimensions. So one thing that we can say is that bricks form walls. Okay? And as an analogy, we can say that unit cells form crystal lattices. And crystal structures are formed by a three-dimensional array of points. And these points in chemistry are going to be atoms. So we can now kind of define what our unit cell and our crystal lattice is. A unit cell is the smallest
piece of the crystal required to show a repeating pattern. And a crystal lattice is the long-range pattern shown by repeating the unit cell.
And we're going to go and investigate what these unit cells are and what these crystal lattices are. And in the next video, we'll specifically focus on cubic unit cells.